been down to their shallow water calving and mating grounds down in Mexico and Baja. So every winter it gets way too cold and frigid for these whales up in the Bering of the Chukchi Sea, so they start the long migration down the coast to where they go to give birth and also mate. The gray whale's migration is the longest migration of any of the mammals, covering about a 4,000 to 5,000 mile journey each direction, taking 2.5 to 3.5 months to complete each whale. The lifespan of these gray whales is believed to be up to about 60 years, and in that time frame with making this annual migration, it's believed that these whales actually swim far enough to make it to the moon and back. Can you put that in perspective? In 60 years, we're swimming about 10,000 miles a year, they can make it to the moon and back. Those slick spots that we see on the surface of the water, those are the whale's footprints or fluke prints. It's caused by the upstroke of the whale's tail. He's up ahead of us here, a little ways, guys. Should be breaking the surface now. There he is, that big flap of steam. And then there's the whale's body. These gray whales are what we would call a baleen whale, which simply means they're filter feeders. So instead of teeth, they have many baleen plates in the tops and bottoms of their mouth that they use to filter out a big mouthful of water and sediment that they'll take up off the seafloor in the Bering and the Chukchi Sea. They'll then push that water and sediment back out through their filter plates, and all that will remain in their mouth is their food. So sort of like how a spaghetti strainer works, that's how these whales feed. Small shrimp-like creatures, plankton, zooplankton, tube worms, stuff like that, that they find on the bottom. And these are actually the only bottom-feeding baleen whale. And they're also the eighth largest of the baleen whales. The largest would be the blue whale. That's the largest animal on the planet, up to 100 foot long. And these gray whales can get to be up to about 50 feet in length. That's on the females. Males don't get to be quite as large as the females, maybe just 40 or 45 feet in length, both weighing nearly a tenth of a foot. Again there, guys, about the 2 o'clock position. Might notice that these whales have two distinct bulbils on the top of their head as we get some closer looks here. That's one of the distinct features of all the baleen whales. They all have two blowholes on the top of their head, and the toothed whales have just one blowhole. There's also some yellow and white markings that you'll see all over these gray whales' bodies. What that yellow stuff is called whale lice. That's a parasite unique only to the gray whales, passed from the mothers to the babies when they're born. That's actually a beneficial parasite. It kind of cleans up the whale's bodies. The whale's cleanup crew, feeding on dead tissue and all that stuff. And the white markings scarring from where barnacles once grew on the whale, but has since fallen off, just leaving behind those markings. These guys are in fact dark brown or black in color, but because of those markings, they appear gray from a distance. Those barnacles that grow on the whale's body are unique to each lagoon that they visit during the wintertime down there in Mexico and Baja. So depending which lagoon they've been to, depends what kind of barnacle they may have on their bodies. See those yellow and white markings that time around?